Growing up, I was so lucky to get to spend lots of time every summer with my Grammy and Poppy. I can honestly say our time together helped mold me into who I am today. My Grammy had no trouble speaking her mind or calling it how she saw it, but man, she sure did love people for exactly who they were. The people she chose to be a part of her life were all different and diverse. It was a beautiful thing. She would tell me, "You can learn a lot from people who are different from you." I will always treasure learning this value from her and vow to instill it in my own children as well. Benjamin Franklin said, "Well done is better than well said." Throughout the years, I remember Grammy always being so thoughtful to her friends, family, neighbors, and church. Some of my most fond memories from when I was little were when we would go with Grammy and Poppy to deliver Meals on Wheels for their church. I carry those special memories with me today through my preschool students by having them decorate holiday placemats to give to the church's Meals on Wheels recipients. This helps me think back on that important time with my big-hearted grandparents. As stated by Paul C. Brownlow, it's true that we only live here once, but if we do it right, once is enough. I think it's safe to say my Grammy did it right. 12 years ago, Grammy suffered her first stroke. That was a game changer for our entire family, but especially for herself. She was always done up from head to toe. Her hair, makeup, clothes, shoes, purse, and jewelry were always styled to a T. She always had things to do and places to be. A verse that has brought me comfort during this time is Matthew 11:28. "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." She carried such a heavy burden for 12 years. I know she desperately needed rest. Rest in the most pure form that can only be found eternally through the Lord our Savior. For the first time in what feels like forever, I know she's rested and renewed, walking with Jesus. And I just know her outfit and her makeup are perfectly coordinated. And I bet that's an incredible feeling for her. I will leave you with a poem. A limb has fallen from the family tree. I keep hearing a voice that says, "Grieve not for me." Remember the best times, the laughter, the song, the good life I lived while I was strong. Continue my heritage, I'm counting on you. Keep smiling and surely the sun will shine through. My mind is at ease, my soul is at rest. Remembering all, how I truly was blessed. Continue traditions, no matter how small. Go on with your life. Don't worry about falls. I miss you all dearly, so keep up your chin until the day comes we're together again.
Thank you, Caitlin. That was beautiful. I invite those gathered to rise as able for the reading of the gospel. The Holy Gospel according to John, the 14th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and I prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place that I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" And Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. You may be seated. Well, Lottie Mabry was known around Christ Lutheran as the consummate gardener. She and Don used to take care of the plants at church, lovingly tending to them, beautifying church spaces, selecting new recruits to spruce up a somber corner here or there. And folks would turn to Lottie for gardening advice. Most special of all, one might find themselves gifted with a clipping from her glorious assortment of flora from home. In speaking with Patty Lynch this week, and much thanks to you, Patty, for our lovely conversation, she shared that Lottie had gifted many of her clippings and plants that Patty has on her gorgeous porch now over the years were from Lottie's own garden. And Patty guessed that other members of the church might have been similarly gifted over the years, and I'm guessing that's very true. And so together we got to imagining how many plants owed their start to Lottie's gardening efforts. And we envisioned how many church members' porches were graced by them now. And we took comfort in the fact that a part of Lottie was alive and well in those plants in such a tangible and vibrant way here and now, still with us. Now, as a pastor, of course, these thoughts bear much fruit, right? Because I couldn't help but think about how that idea of how many things that she's planted and grown here and how they will outlive her reminded me of how she herself was grafted into the vine of God's life of grace and love and beauty through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Because we knew Lottie was a woman of faith, right? A deep woman of faith. And we learn in Scripture that Jesus is the vine, and we are the branches, and we are grafted then into the life of Christ. And it most certainly seems that Lottie was grafted into that vine, Jesus, into the very life-giving love of Jesus. Because we remember her as this woman of faith, active in her church, giving of her time to those in need through Meals on Wheels, like Caitlin said, but other opportunities as well. She used to organize fellowship events for church and help out again with the plants that were here. She gave of her time as there was need. And she certainly gave of that time to all of you, her family. And I've heard and shared with you some of those powerful stories of her as a beloved wife, mother, grandmother, and great-grandmother. Because the truth is, Lottie tended to humans even more than she tended to her beloved plants. She was a caregiver and a caretaker, and I think that's because she was grafted into the vine that is Jesus Christ. She knew who her Savior was, she knew where her discipleship lay, and so she lived a life of joyful giving and love. Don, Lottie's husband of 65 years, chose today's scripture readings. And one can't help but notice in our reading from Romans the part about suffering. We all mourn that Lottie had to spend so much of her life under pain and hardship of her physical limitations. I mourn that I've known her for 10 years and never got to see her before. You know, she'd had those strokes which limited her so much. But we can also take comfort that being grafted into Jesus means that he is there with you in your sufferings. That's one of the things we confess as Christians. And so we believe that he was present with Lottie throughout all of those sufferings that she experienced. Now, Don, I have to take a moment to say you have served so faithfully by Lottie's side. I'm going to tear up now. Many know that you should be sainted for the faithful love that you have shown your dear Lottie over these years. And now we can all take comfort, but I hope especially you, that her suffering has ended and that she is reunited in heaven with her Lord and Savior with that great outfit on and that great makeup that Caitlin talked about. Being grafted in Jesus means that we are grafted into his suffering and death, but it also means that we are grafted into his resurrection and new life. As Jesus says in our gospel, he has gone on to prepare a place for each of us, and we take comfort that he has prepared a place for our dear Lottie, his beloved daughter. I imagine this place for her, this room that he's prepared, to be a garden. I imagine it to have the most verdant foliage, a place with rolling hills as described in our psalm, a place where the river of the city of God flows, bearing water to all of creation, a place where birds and bees flit about from flower to flower, a place where you can smell the sweet smell of those flowers waft toward your nose, a place where Lottie can rest, free from the shackles of her earthly body, and freed to love and tend to those she loves the most, whether here or there. Because I want you to know that Lottie continues to be with each of you, just like those plants that grace the porches of so many throughout San Antonio because of her love. She lives in each of you. There is a part of her grafted into each of you. And nothing can take that away from you. Nothing can change that. She will live on. She will forever abide in you and you in her. Just as our Lord and Savior says, I am the vine and you are the branches. I abide in you and you abide in me. And we know because of that, she is abiding in heaven with God and yet still connected here with all of us. Amen.
Thank you.
I invite the congregation to stand as able. Together we confess our common faith, the faith into which Lottie was baptized. I believe in God, the Father Almighty.
I believe in Jesus Christ, my only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He ascended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
I invite the congregation to kneel as able for our prayers. Let us pray. Almighty God, in holy baptism, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life in Christ. God of mercy, give courage and faith to all who mourn, and a sure and certain hope in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, they may have strength for the days ahead. God of mercy, hear our prayer. Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. God of mercy. Help us in the midst of things we cannot understand to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. God of mercy, God of all grace, we give you thanks because by his death our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life nor things present nor things to come will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. I invite the congregation to rise as we continue with the meal. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
Holy, mighty, and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He broke it and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be all honor and glory, now and forever. Amen. And let us pray together the prayer our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. At this time, I invite you to partake of Christ's body and blood. The wafers are on top of the small cup you received, and the wine is in the bottom. The body of Christ given for you. The blood of Christ shed for you.
Dwell in dark and sin, my hand will sing.
And now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray together. Almighty God, we thank you that in your great love, you have given us a foretaste of your heavenly banquet. Grant that this sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction and a pledge of our inheritance of life eternal, where there is no death, neither sorrow nor crying, but the fullness of joy with all your saints, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us now commend Lottie to the mercy of God, our Maker and our Redeemer. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Lottie. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.